Every year in Britain, somewhere between 17 and 20 million tons of food is wasted and ends up
in skips like these
and bins like these.
That 20 million tons of waste represents approximately one third of all food in Britain and would be enough to feed 30 million malnourished people around the world. In the midst of a global food crisis and with Britain in its worst economic slump since the Second World War, can we really afford to be so wasteful? I met up with Paul, Ulrika and Alan, three people known as Freegans, who dedicate their lives to fighting waste by using as little money as possible and living almost entirely on wasted food raided from bins and supermarket skips.
All right, well, thanks for having me then.
No worries.
Is this today? Is this food from bins today? Or?
That's the it's all, I think the only thing we actually bought there was the spinach.
Cool.
We didn't have, couldn't find the greens.
But, got to get balance.
Everything else.
We got mashed potato and mashed carrot.
Yeah,
cool.
Yeah.
How much of your food would be taken from bins and how much would sort of, would you?
About 80% of 80%. The food. 80% of the food we get from the bin. So.
But you must have some need for money. I mean, do you work at all or how does that?
No, we work voluntarily.
Yeah.
And none of us receive like unemployment benefits from the government or anything like that. So, we go on the street most days and tell other people about Freegan ideals and stuff and pass out literature along those lines.
Yeah.
And we ask for a penny or two for the literature.
Yeah.
So sometimes people give you literally a penny or two and sometimes people give you a bit more.
Paul was very quick to point out that Freegans did not claim unemployment benefits, and his defensive attitude made me wonder whether himself and other Freegans often have to face accusations of freeloading and being carried by other, more conventional, tax-paying members of society.
Yeah. Would you say it's the argument that, you know, you're not paying tax, should you benefit from NHS, education?
Well, we're actually contributing to society too, but paying income tax, that's how this NHS business is paid for, but we feel like we're doing something as well by contributing our experimentation on living on less and being able to share that lifestyle with other people as well.
I agree totally with Paul that anyone living in Britain should have complete access to state services regardless of their ability to pay tax. However, I was less convinced about the contribution he claimed Freeganism makes to society. So to get a better idea, I went along with Paul on my first bin raiding experience.
Yeah, we just started looking at Tesco's Express bins and we were immediately challenged by a security guy. He was okay, pretty friendly. He just said, "What are you doing?" I said, "I'm looking for some food waste. Right away," and he said, "We haven't got any."
So
he was okay about it. Yes. He said, "Okay, boss," he said.
Paul had assured me that we'd have no trouble at all finding food, but after three unsuccessful raids, I was beginning to wonder whether supermarkets really throw away as much food as I'd been told.
They used to be there where all this rubbish is, and now they put a fence around them, So we're not coming up with, we're coming up with a lot of disappointments tonight.
But as the sun set on an hour of hard searching, we finally hit the jackpot.
They're free. Potatoes. They're £1.50 a pound. Potatoes.
You okay?
Radishes. Oh, that's chewing a good radish.
To go through, we'd probably find a bit more, but that's enough for our needs. So.
In order to really understand what it was like to be a Freegan, I decided I'd have to try it myself. So I've set myself a challenge to go exactly 1 week without spending a single penny on food, and I won't be allowed to accept food from friends, family or anyone I know.
right, I'm starting my challenge tomorrow, so I'm going out tonight to get some provisions in. But it's my first time, so I'm a little bit nervous. So I've waited till the dead of night, and I'm wearing completely black clothes. So black T-shirt, black trousers, as dark as I could find, so I completely blend in with the shadows, and basically no one will see me. But it has just started raining, so I'm just going to put a coat on. Right, let's go. It was my first time bin raiding, so I started off in the relative safety of my home turf, a small spa tucked away on Birmingham University campus. Venturing further afield, I travelled up to Sainsbury's to find out if I really would taste the difference.
Loads of bread rolls. Bunch of grapes.
Spurred on by my first find, I went to the Co-op and Summerfield as well that night and returned home with a bag of food fit for a king.
Right, I've just got back from my first bin raiding experience. I think I've done quite well. This is my bag of goodies. So let's see what I've got. Okay, lots of bread, loads of bread rolls. Lovely bunch of grapes, some carrots, so quite a bit of fruit and veg, two king prawn and rocket sandwiches, but I'll probably take the king prawns out of those, meat feast, but again, probably take out the meat, just have the feast, two carrot slices, custard slices, and a cheese and tomato pizza, so not too bad at all. I think that might keep me going for a couple of days.
The total value of the food came out at approximately £16, which was great, until I woke up to breakfast the next morning. It took me 12 and a half minutes to munch my way through four rounds of dry toast. My first bin raid had shown me that I clearly wasn't going to starve, but I wasn't going to have much fun either. Also, there was something about the creeping round that didn't sit quite right with me. Even though the food had been thrown away, it still felt a bit like stealing. I decided I would try to find other ways of getting food to supplement my skip diet. I'd heard of a website called Freecycle, where people traded unwanted items, and decided to look it up.